नमो तस्स भगवतो अरहतो सम्मा संबुद्धस्स। नमो तस्स भगवतो अरहतो सम्मा संबुद्धस्स। नमो तस्स भगवतो अरहतो सम्मा संबुद्धस्स। वेलकम टू फंडामेंटल्स ऑफ बुद्धिज्म, अ फ्री ईकोस बीइंग ऑफर्ड बाय धम्म यूएसए अंडर द गाइडेंस ऑफ वेनरेबल भंते सुमित। हाउ टू लर्न बुद्धिज्म, दैट इज द की क्वेश्चन। Let us begin today's lecture by paying homage to the Supreme Buddha, the Self-Enlightened One. May I request Bhanteji to administer the five precepts and Sister Arpana to repeat after him. Sadhu, sadhu, sadhu.
Okay, please say sadhu, sadhu, sadhu and say namo tassa bhagavato arahato samma sambuddhassa three times to observe the five precepts.
Namo tassa bhagavato arahato samma sambuddhassa. नमो तस्स भगवतो अरहतो सम्मा संबुद्धस्स। नमो तस्स भगवतो अरहतो सम्मा संबुद्धस्स।
बुद्धं शरणं गच्छामि।
बुद्धं शरणं गच्छामि।
धम्मं शरणं गच्छामि।
धम्मं शरणं गच्छामि।
संघं शरणं गच्छामि।
संघं शरणं गच्छामि।
द्वितीयं पे बुद्धं शरणं गच्छामि।
द्वितीयं पे बुद्धं शरणं गच्छामि।
द्वितीयं पे धम्मं शरणं गच्छामि।
द्वितीयम्पि धम्मं शरणं गच्छामि।
द्वितीयम्पि संघं शरणं गच्छामि।
द्वितीयम्पि संघं शरणं गच्छामि।
तृतीयम्पि बुद्धं शरणं गच्छामि।
तृतीयम्पि बुद्धं शरणं गच्छामि।
तथेयं ते धम्मं शरणं गच्छामि।
तथेयम्पि धम्मं शरणं गच्छामि।
तथेयं ते संघं शरणं गच्छामि।
तथेयम्पि संघं शरणं गच्छामि।
शरणागमनं सम्पूर्णं।
आं भन्ते।
पानातिपाता वीरमणि सिक्खापदं समादयामि।
पानातिपाता वीरमणि सिक्खापदं समादयामि।
अदिन्नादान वीरमणि सिक्खापदं समादयामि।
अदिन्नादान वीरमणि सिक्खापदं समादयामि।
कामेषु मिच्छाचारा वीरमणि सिक्खापदं समादयामि।
कामेषु मिच्छाचारा वीरमणि सिक्खापदं समादयामि।
मुसावादा वीरमणि सिक्खापदं समादयामि।
मुसावादा वीरमणि सिक्खापदं समादयामि।
सुरामेरय मज्जपमा दट्ठाना वीरमणि सिक्खापदं समादयामि।
सुरामेरय मज्जपमा दट्ठाना वीरमणि सिक्खापदं समादयामि।
तिसरणेन सद्धिं पञ्चशीलं धम्मं साधुकं सुरक्षितं कत्वा अपमादेन संपादे तब्बं।
साधु साधु साधु। मध्य जी, मे आई शेयर स्क्रीन? यस, आई एम एबल टू डू इट। Namo Buddhaye, Namo Dhammaye, Namo Sanghaye. Let us begin today's topic in Fundamentals of Buddhism, which is Buddhism and Animals. Animals have always been regarded in Buddhist thought as sentient beings. So, sirf human beings are sentient beings nahi hain, balki animals bhi hain. Furthermore, animals possess Buddha nature, according to the Mahayana school of Buddhism, and therefore they have potential for enlightenment. Moreover, the doctrine of rebirth held that any human could be reborn as an animal. ये हमारे कुशल या अकुशल कर्म पे डिपेंड करता है कि हम किस रेम ऑफ एग्जिस्टेंस में रीबर्थ लेते हैं. एंड एनी एनिमल कुड बी रीबॉर्न एज अ ह्यूमन. बुद्धिज्म रिक्वायर्स अस टू ट्रीट एनिमल्स काइंडली. बुद्धिस्ट ट्राई टू डू नो हार्म और एज लिटिल एज पॉसिबल टू एनिमल्स. Buddhists try to show loving kindness to all beings, including animals. The doctrine of right livelihood teaches Buddhists to avoid any work connected with the killing of animals. So, panati pata ki jo hum baat karte hain, to isme animals bhi aate hain. The doctrine of karma teaches that any wrong behavior will have to be paid for in a future life. Isliye cruel acts to animals should be avoided. Buddhists treat the lives of human and non-human animals with equal respect. Buddhists see human and non-human animals as closely related. Both have Buddha nature. Both have the possibility of becoming perfectly enlightened. Soul means person or sentient being, the five aggregates. A soul may be reborn either in a human body or in the body of a non-human animal. So, jab hum rebirth le sakte hain as an animal, to animals ko janna aur samajhna bahut avashyak hai. Buddhists believe that it is wrong to hurt or kill animals because all beings are afraid of injury and death. In the Dhammapada, in verse 129, it is stated, all living things fear being beaten with clubs. All living things fear being put to death. Putting oneself in the place of the other, let no one kill nor cause another to kill. Like other forms of Buddhism, Tibetan Buddhism tradition recognizes karta hai that animals like humans are sentient beings capable of emotions and some level of thought. अब जिसने भी पेट्स रखे हैं या एनिमल्स के साथ फ्रेंडशिप रखी है वो इस बात को बहुत अच्छी तरह समझेंगे. As such, there is no question that animals are capable of suffering and that humans should consider their needs when making ethical decisions. They have a fundamental similarity with humans and are less intelligent and capable than humans. तो हम कुशल कर्म कर सकते हैं by helping animals. This is my pet family member, Kipper, Lhasa Apso, a Tibetan breed, who passed away about 3 years ago. They feel physical pain, of course, but they also feel emotions such as fear, love, and desire. This view of animals' moral standing is reflected not only in theoretical texts, but also in a wide variety of practices aimed at reducing animal suffering. Kuch sutras ke names diye hain reference ke liye, jisme aap further study kar sakte hain. Lankavatar Sutra of Mahayana Buddhism, Mahaparinirvan Sutra, ye Theravad Buddhism aur sub branches of Buddhism mein aata hai. Surangam Sutra of Mahayana Buddhism. We often come across pictures of the Tathagata surrounded by animals. This is Mangal Maitri. Namo Tassa Bhagavato Arahato Samma Sambuddhassa. Sadhu, sadhu, sadhu. This is the end of the first part. I will show you some others also. Now we come to the second one. So welcome back to Buddhism and Animals, part two. In this, we are going to talk of animal liberation and animal blessing. In the Buddhist sense, animal liberation means rescuing animals from impending death and then giving them dharma by undertaking certain Buddhist practices, including circumambulation, yani ki parikrama karna, and mantra recitation. It is usually done as a practice for long life and removing life obstacles, the merits being dedicated to someone else with specific obstacles as well as to all living beings. An animal blessing, on the other hand, will include the same practices of circumambulation and mantra recitation, but the animal involved has not necessarily been recently rescued from death, for example, someone's pet. Tum apne pets ke liye kar sakte hain, aur in general, sab animals ke liye kar sakte hain, jaise animals who are being kept in zoos or wildlife sanctuaries. Whichever activity you are undertaking, liberation or blessing, such Buddhist practices to help animals have many benefits. They help the animals, the people doing the practices, and those for whom the practices are dedicated. At the same time, however, kuch risks bhi hote hain aur saath mein responsibilities bhi hain. Of utmost importance is the care of those living beings by practitioners, whether temporarily, prior to release into the wild, or long-term as pets or at a sanctuary. Jaise zoos or circuses mein animals ko rakha jata hai, to wildlife se jo hum leke aate hain, to kuch time baad wo bahut bechain, bahut restless ho jate hain. Unki aankhein bhi bilkul dull ho jati hain. To ye zaruri nahi hai ki hum saalon saal unko zoos mein ya circuses mein qaid karke rakhein. साल डेढ़ साल बाद उनको रिलीज कर सकते हैं वाइल्ड में, उसके बाद नए एनिमल ला सकते हैं, फिर उनको रिलीज कर सकते हैं. एंड दिस प्रैक्टिस हैज बीन वेरी सक्सेसफुली फॉलोड. डॉल्फिन पार्क्स में भी ऐसा किया जाता है. व्हाइल बुद्धिस्ट बिलीव द कर्मिक बेनिफिट ऑफ डूइंग दीज प्रैक्टिसेस विल बी ऑनगोइंग एंड परहैप्स हैव अ ग्रेटर इफेक्ट इन फ्यूचर लाइफ, द वेलफेयर ऑफ दीज एनिमल्स इन दिस लाइफ इज ऑल्सो क्रिटिकल. Animals should be handled and cared for as the kind mother sentient beings we are taught that they are, and as the fragile living creatures that share our planet and suffer physically, mentally, and emotionally. Animal blessings ki baat karte hain. Several FPMT centers. FPMT is a very famous organization. It stands for Foundation for the Preservation of Mahayana Texts. इनकी वेबसाइट भी है. These centers are now conducting animal blessings, particularly on World Animal Day, which is October 4th. What should we do when we make arrangement for such an event? Be mindful of predator and prey relationships. जैसे जो बड़े डॉग्स हैं तो उनके साथ छोटे डॉग्स को मत रखिए, क्योंकि बड़े वाले बहुत अग्रेसिव होते हैं. Provide water for the animals to drink. और वाटर सप्लाई होना चाहिए, वाटर बोल्स होने चाहिए डिफरेंट साइजेस के एनिमल्स के लिए. अगर आप स्नैक्स दे रहे हैं पेट्स को तो दूसरे पेट्स जेलस हो जाते हैं, आपस में फाइटिंग भी हो सकती है. ओवर हीटिंग या ओवर कोल्ड होना भी हार्मफुल होता है एनिमल्स के लिए, तो सूटेबल शेड और शेल्टर प्रोवाइड करना चाहिए. जैसे डॉग शोज और कैट शोज होते हैं तो उसमें इन बातों का हम लोग ध्यान रख सकते हैं. अगर कई घंटों तक एनिमल्स को वेट करना पड़े शो के लिए तो उसमें वो बीमार भी पड़ सकते हैं और परेशान भी बहुत हो जाते हैं. एनिमल केयर इन द बुद्धिस्ट ट्रेडिशन. व्हेन यू स्टार्ट मेडिटेटिंग ऑन द ट्रिमेंडस अमाउंट ऑफ सफरिंग दैट एनिमल्स हैव टू अंडरगो ऑन अ प्लैनेट, यू विल रिकॉग्नाइज दैट ऑल लिविंग बीइंग्स एंड इवन द स्मॉलेस्ट इंसेक्ट दैट बग्स यू वॉन्ट एग्जैक्टली द सेम एज यू. बिल्कुल हमारी तरह है एनिमल्स. To be happy and to be free from suffering. Here is a quote by the Dalai Lama, His Holiness. Today, together with the growing appreciation of the importance of human rights, there is a greater awareness worldwide of the need for the protection not only of the environment, but also of animals and their rights. Where there is a mind, there are feelings such as pain, pleasure, and joy. No sentient being wants pain. Instead, all want happiness. Since we all share these feelings at some basic level, we as rational human beings have an obligation to contribute in whatever way we can to the happiness of other species and try our best to relieve their fears and suffering. What you can do for your pet. Animals such as your cat or dog give you unconditional love and joy. There are so many things you can do for them in return in the Tibetan Buddhist way of thinking. When you become more and more conscious and open your heart to animals, you might want to help animals in the same way as Lama Zopa Rinpoche and Dagri Rinpoche do and blow mantras on animals. The mantras that are most used in Tibetan Buddhism to bless animals are called the five powerful mantras. Agar aapke yahan pets hain, to definitely ye mantras ki recitation ki aadat daliye. Jab bhi wo bimar ho ya kamzor ho jaye aur aapko lage ki death impending hai, to inka ucharan start kar dijiye. The first is the Maitreya mantra. Om Muni Mohi Maha Mohi Soha. This is the heart mantra. Dusra hai Padma Sambhav mantra. Om Ahum Vajra Guru Padma Siddhi Hum. Third is the Chandrasekhar mantra, jo sabse popular hai, Om Mani Padme Hum. Ye short mantra hai, iska ek long mantra aapke pet ya animal ke liye bhi hai, jo aapko fpmt.org website pe mil jayega aur www.enlightenmentforanimals.org. This extremely powerful Buddhist mantra heals emotions and liberates beings from the animal realm also. Agar hum apne pets se genuinely pyar karte hain, if we love them unconditionally in return for their unconditional love, to hame pray karne chahiye, mantra ucharan karna chahiye, jisse ki unko ek fortunate rebirth mile. Animal realm se wo bahar aa jayein. Human rebirth ho ya nirvan attain kare. According to Lama Zopa Rinpoche, the benefits of reciting the Compassion Buddha mantra are infinite, like the limitless sky. Not only will reciting this mantra bring your animal comfort at the time of transition, yani ki transition from this realm of existence to the next, the effects of this mantra will be felt for lifetimes to come. This makes a huge difference. It has inconceivable result, unbelievable result. This practice will plant the seed of all the realizations of the path to enlightenment that makes them have a good rebirth next life to be born as a human being and meet the dharma. Number four, a medicine Buddha mantra. Bimari ke time pe avashya karna chahiye aur death ke baad bhi karna chahiye. Tayata om bekanze bekanze maha bekanze raja samudgathe soha. Fifth is the Milarepa mantra. Om ahas vajra sarva siddhi phal hum. Aapka pet hai ghar mein, to definitely ye sab baatein ko samajhna chahiye aur uski benefit ke liye use karna chahiye jisse ki fortunate rebirth mile. Hum log sangh ke liye kehte hain ki ye ek punya khetam hai. It is an unsurpassed field of merit. The same applies to the other realms of existence. We dedicate our merit to all beings, all devas, all sentient beings everywhere. And we should specially mention animals also. Agar hamare pets hain, to unke liye to hamare mein ek vishesh responsibility hai. Your pet. If you love your animal very much, this is what you must do for them, for their good rebirth and quick liberation from samsara. When the animal is dying or has died, recite Om Mani Padme Hum. Haruka mantra, Haruka root mantra, and other mantras, such as the Milarepa and Nam Gyalma mantras. You can recite the long mantras 21 times or more, and one mala or more of the short mantras. Blow strongly, phook marte hain mantra karte hue, on the animal's body after each recitation, or you can blow on water, visualizing each deity absorbed into the water. Each drop of water now has the power to purify negative karmas. Then, as you pour the water on the animal, all its negative karmas are purified. हम लोग कुशल कर्म करते हैं जिससे कि जो हमने अकुशल कर्म प्रीवियस बर्थ में किए थे या इस बर्थ में भी कर रहे हैं वो करेक्ट हो जाएं और हमें निबान मिले या फॉर्चुनेट रीबर्थ मिले. अब एनिमल्स कुशल कर्म कैसे करें? उनकी एक्शन, उनका बिहेवियर तो सब इंस्टिंक्टिव होता है. माइंड एक लिमिटेड लेवल तक होता है, इसलिए हम उनको हेल्प कर सकते हैं. और हेल्प करने से एनिमल्स को तो फायदा ही, साथ में हमारे लिए ये कुछ कुशल कर्म हो जाता है. इफ द एनिमल इज डाइंग, यू कैन डू मेडिसिन बुद्धा प्रैक्टिस, विजुअलाइजिंग द सेवन मेडिसिन बुद्धास ऑन द क्राउन ऑफ द एनिमल. दिस हैज बीन कोटेड फ्रॉम लामा ज़ोपा रिनपोचे. This is His Venerable, His Holiness. Tibetan Buddhist pet animal blessing, Amitabha Mantra, ye bahut special hai. Om Ami Deva Hri. This is to help transfer animals to pure land. It is recited to the Buddhist deity Bodhisattva Amitabha, who embodies pure discernment and light. Perhaps this is the best known Buddha mantra after Om Mani Padme Hum. And it is the name mantra of Amitabha Buddha. And for many people, Amitabha Buddha practice is profound and complete. In its shortest form, this practice entails simply sitting and chanting this amazing mantra as many times as possible. YouTube में इसकी videos भी मिल जाएंगी, हम link share करेंगे WhatsApp group में. आप सिर्फ इसको play भी कर सकते हैं. As a casino, इसको use करके meditation की जा सकती है, walking meditation कर सकते हैं या सिर्फ play कर दीजिए. As your mind relaxes into the mantra, you will find the peace and light of Amitabha Buddha. Recite as many times as you can a mantra of your choice. Then blow over the dead body of the animal or insect. If possible, bury or cremate the body. ऐसे ही फेंकना नहीं चाहिए. हम अपने फैमिली मेंबर्स के साथ ऐसा नहीं करते. एंड वी शुड कंसिडर ऑल सेंटिएंट बीइंग्स एज इक्वल. एनिमल्स स्पेशली डिजर्व अ कंपैशन अलॉट, क्योंकि आजकल दुनिया में देखिए बहुत तरह के अत्याचार हो रहे हैं एनिमल्स पर. डूइंग दिस आउट ऑफ ग्रेट कंपैशन इज द बेस्ट रीजन एंड इट विल अर्न यू सम ट्रिमेंडस अमाउंट ऑफ गुड कर्मा. डूइंग दिस बिकॉज ऑफ वॉन्टिंग टू अर्न सम गुड कर्मा वेर इट is also a good reason. It will work as well. Buddha Sasanam Chiram Tittitu. Why? Because this is the teaching of the Buddha. Compassion for all beings. Now I will go to the third one. So now we are in Buddhism and animals, part 3. We are going to talk of animals in the Jataka tales of karma and rebirth. Can the animals in the Jataka tales teach humans about the nuances of coexistence and compassion? Aisa kaha jata hai ki insaan sabse bada darinda hai. Asli animal to hum hi log hain. हम लोग जो अत्याचार कर सकते हैं और करते हैं दूसरों पे, एनिमल्स वो नहीं करते. सो इट इज वी ह्यूमंस हु नीड टू लर्न कोएग्जिस्टेंस एंड कंपैशन. इफ एनिमल्स कुड टॉक, व्हाट वुड दे टेल अस? इट्स अ क्वेश्चन दैट मेनी हैव वंडर्ड. और ये एक ऐसा क्वेश्चन है दैट एंशिएंट बुद्धिस्ट स्कॉलर्स हैव ट्राइड टू आंसर थ्रू द जातका टेल्स. द टेल्स आर स्टोरीज कंपाइल्ड बिटवीन 200 and 400 BC that are popular to this day amongst Buddhists and children alike. One aspect of what makes the tale so timeless remains its animal characters. Animals, that is living beings with the same desire for survival and fear of death as humans, serve as mouthpieces for hard truths about both the world we live in and the way we live in it. The narrative takes the reader through the past lives of the Buddha. Moments in time when the Buddha is reincarnated, in forms ranging from that of a goat to that of a monkey and sometimes as human participants in exchanges concerning animals. I'll quote as Buddhist scholar Reiko Onuma and professor of religion at Dartmouth College, who says to be reincarnated as an animal is an unfortunate destiny in the Buddhist purview. This idea lends itself aptly to the title of a 2017 book, Unfortunate Destiny, Animals in the Indian Buddhist Imagination. In Buddhist belief, one can be reincarnated as a variety of animals, non-human and human alike. To be reborn as a human is a privilege, for being reincarnated as an animal is seen as a downgrade. They are described by the Buddha in the Bala Pandit Sutta as, and I quote, having no righteous conduct, no tranquil conduct, no wholesome action, no meritorious action. There is only mutual devouring and devouring of the weak. Ye animal life, instinctive, survival of the fittest. Animal realm ke baare mein kuch study karte hain. It is the state of existence of a being as an animal, terya. This realm is traditionally thought to be similar to a hellish realm, bilkul nark jaisa jeevan hota hai, because animals are believed in Buddhist texts to be driven by impulse and instinct. They prey on each other and suffer. What are the six realms in Buddhism? The six levels that make up the possible range of existence within samsara. These are the realms of the gods, deva, the demigods, asura, humans, manusya, animals, tiryak, hungry ghosts, preta, and hell denizens, narak. Rebirths occur in six realms of existence, namely three good or higher realms, ye hai heavenly, demigod, and human, and three evil or lower realms, animal, ghost, and hellish. Sansara ends if a person attains nirvana, the blowing out of the desires and the gaining of true insight into impermanence and non-self reality. There are six enlightened Buddhas that exist in each of the six realms. These six Buddhas have also been known as the six sages. The name is Thirasimha, Buddha in the animal realm. Buddhist cosmology typically identifies six realms of rebirth and existence. The six realms are organized into 31 levels in East Asian literature. Now let us talk of cause and end. Sansara is perpetuated by one's karma, which is caused by craving and ignorance, that is avidya or avijja. Dekhiye isme Sanskrit terms kahi aati hain kyunki Mahayana tradition mein originally sutras jo hain wo Sanskrit mein likhe gaye the, aur Tibetan Buddhism mein bhi jo earliest literature hai wo Sanskrit mein hi hai ya Sanskrit literature se translate ki gayi hai, and to date they use Sanskrit terms a lot. Wo dhamma kam bolte hain aur dharma adhik bolte hain. Cause and end ki discussion continue karte hain. In the Buddhist view, therefore, the type of birth one has in this life is determined by actions or karma from the previous lives. And the circumstances of the future rebirth are determined by the actions in the current and previous lives. Theory of karma and rebirth mein, or dependent origination, in subtopics mein hum already study kar chuke hain. What is the psychological interpretation of the animal realm? According to Chogyam Trungpa, the realms of samsara can refer to both psychological states of mind and physical cosmological realms. Ho sakta hai hum animal ke roop mein punarjan paaye, ya ho sakta hai hamara jan aise person ki tarah jo bilkul janwar jaisa instinct aur janwar jaisa behavior rakhta ho, jo insaan to lagta hi nahi ho. Gethin argues, a very famous Buddhist scholar, rebirth in the different realms is determined by one's karma, which is directly determined by one's psychological states. The Buddhist cosmology may thus be seen as a map of different realms of existence and a description of all possible psychological experiences. The psychological states of a person in current life lead to the nature of next rebirth in Buddhist cosmology. The four planes of deprivation, apaya. These lowest four unhappy planes are infernal states in which beings pay the price for akusala, demeritorious acts committed in their previous life. Buddhists believe that beings are born as animals on account of evil karma. Upa plus aya is equal to devoid of happiness. These four states of unhappiness are viewed both as mental states and as places. They are also called dugati. Tirachana yoni. Tiru means across. Achana means going. There is the possibility for animals to be born as human beings as a result of the good karma accumulated in the past. It may be remarked that at times, certain animals, particularly dogs and cats, live a more comfortable life than even some human beings due to their past good karma. Terachan loka or animal world. This is not a pleasant plane as beings have to search for food and fight each other to stay alive. So the animal realm is characterized by fight or flight. The animal realm may seem like a tempting rebirth, especially if you have ever had the fantasy of soaring like an eagle or frolicking in the waves like a dolphin. But the day-to-day life of a wild animal, wo animal chahe kitna majestic kyun na ho, involves a fair amount of eat or be eaten, and there is little time and inclination for seeking spiritual enlightenment. Also, since invertebrates, jo backbone ke bina animals hote hain, worms ki tarah, make up about 95% of all animal life on earth, there's a much higher chance of being reborn as a spineless worm than as a soaring eagle. Being reborn as an animal is especially frightening in a world dominated by humans. Animals have little power to influence the larger world around them and are often the first to feel the effects of human development and environmental destruction. It is a life of ignorant complacency and dullness in which one doesn't look beyond avoiding pain and seeking comfort. Such images of the Sangha members with animals are extremely common. Bodhisattvas, Buddhas are often seen with animals. This is the white elephant who appeared in a dream to Queen Mahamaya. Sadhu, sadhu, sadhu. Let me go to the fourth one now. So now we are in Buddhism and Animals, part four. Just a moment. Symbolism of animals in Buddhism. We will describe the different symbols both in their outer and inner or esoteric meaning according to the different teachings of Lord Buddha. However, according to the Buddhist teachings, the very physical existence of any phenomena is dependent on the inner meaning, which is due to the mental creation or karmic activity of the sentient being. Hum jaisa jeevan bitate hain to kuch vastuon ke kuch objects ke symbols ya symbolism usi tarike ka ban jata hai. Esoteric word ka meaning kya hai? It is referred originally to the secret teachings of Greek philosophers. Number one, esoteric means intended for or likely to be understood by only a small number of people with a specialized knowledge or interest or an enlightened inner circle. So Buddhism is both a religion and a philosophy of life. Aur animals to sabko bahut sweet lagte hain. Isliye har kisi ko malum hona chahiye ki animals ki kya status hai Buddhism mein. Second meaning hai, having to do with concepts that are highly theoretical and without obvious practical application, often with mystical or religious connotations. That means that the fact that the symbols do exist is due to the mental or karmic creation of those beings and cannot exist without it. Hamare mind mein jo thoughts hain, jo culture hai, jo society hai, uske anusar symbols hote hain. Just as a plant needs a seed in order to come into existence, in the same way, the plant as a symbol exists only because there is a karmic seed which causes it. Therefore, जिन ऑब्जेक्ट्स को हम सिंबल्स कहते हैं वो आर्टिफिशियल नहीं है कल्चरल क्रिएशंस इन्वेंटेड बाय समबडी बट दे कॉरेस्पॉन्ड टू अ रियल कर्मिक एक्टिविटी हमारी लाइफ का एक हिस्सा है which manifests in the external level as a material object, a plant or animal in this case, and in the internal mental level, it corresponds to a mental experience. Even ordinary beings can perceive to some extent the real nature of symbols. But in order to get a clearer understanding, some intellectual explanations are needed. The actual reality of these symbols has been experienced directly in meditation by those highly realized beings like Sakyamuni Buddha and others. They somehow discovered the real nature of the symbols through their pure vision and understanding. Generally, the Buddhist as well as other religious symbols are considered as a cultural item, aur hum log understand nahi karte ki unki real significance kya hai. They are used or venerated kyunki ye ek tradition hai hamari ek country ka, ya hum believe karte hain ki ye symbols ye objects good luck or prosperity lekar aayenge, jaise ki kamal ka phool hai, lotus flower. In fact, these symbols not only can bring good luck, long life and prosperity, but can also bring the highest realization of the real nature of all existences. They can help sentient beings to develop their own inner wisdom and attain the level of a Buddha, no matter what other name they want to give to it. And that is why these symbols do exist as manifestations of this wisdom inherent in all sentient beings' minds. Sorry. In this presentation, only a few animals have been described briefly. The use of animal symbols is an important part of Buddhism and embodies the idea that everything that is alive possesses an inherent virtue, power, and wisdom. Animal symbols contain secret meanings related to specific characteristics of the animals they represent and highlight the Buddha's relation to nature, kindness, humanistic ideas, emphasizing the relationship between Buddha's theory and practice. अपने लिए बुद्धिज्म प्रैक्टिस करना, अपने जैसे अपने रिलेटिव्स और फ्रेंड्स के लिए प्रैक्टिस करना, संघ के लिए प्रैक्टिस करना, ये तो सभी करते हैं क्योंकि हमें इससे फायदा होता है, और कुछ नहीं तो सोसाइटी में ही फायदा हो जाता है. लेकिन जो कंपैशन का पात्र है, सही अधिकारी है, जिस पर इतना अत्याचार हो रहा है, जैसे एनिमल्स, दे आर वेरी मच डिपेंडेंट ऑन अस एंड वी कैन डू अ ग्रेट डील. उनको स्टडी करेंगे हम. I will go through it very fast because we are going to share these PDF notes in the WhatsApp group. Lion is the first symbol. Inko animal kingdom ka king mana jata hai. They are proud and majestic. Ye plains or grassy hills mein rehte hain. High snow mountains mein nahi rehte hain. They are organized into clans or groups. They don't live alone, except in case of old lions ya jinko community se bahar nikal dete hain. Next hai deer. In Buddhism, deer symbolize peace, harmony, and longevity. They are by nature gentle and serene, and their presence represents the purity of a sacred place. Jaise Sarnath ka deer park, isi patan, bereft of fear. Foremost, the deer symbolize the Buddha's most essential teachings and the act of receiving them. It was in the deer park that the Buddha gave his first teaching. The Buddha is often shown sitting on a dais with two deer kneeling facing each other. Many monasteries feature the dharma wheel, with two deer sitting on each side, gazing steadily at the wheel with great joy. Deer are also represented in the Jataka tales, which are fables attributed to the past lives of the Buddha as human and animal, with messages of wisdom and compassion. Dragons, jo ki China, Japan mein bahut popular hain. In India, Nagas are water spirits. They are depicted as huge cobras or as half human and half snake. Mahayana or Theravad mythology mein, they play a role as protectors of the Buddha and the Sutras. Ek legend mein, there's a Naga king named Muchalinda, who sheltered the Buddha during a heavy rain just after the Buddha's enlightenment. He coiled around the Buddha's body and transformed his hood into an umbrella over the Buddha's head. Buddha statues that symbolize this legend are famous in Burma, Laos, and Thailand. As Buddhism spread through China, Nagas became identified as dragons. Buddhists offer vases of jewels to Nagas for abundant crops, health, and children, as well as to stop epidemics, earthquakes, and floods. Nagas are vulnerable to contamination by water pollution and deforestation. They will protect people who protect nature. लायन के बारे में थोड़ा सा डिटेल में देखते हैं. लायन इज अ सिंबल ऑफ रॉयल्टी, स्ट्रेंथ एंड ब्रेवरी. द लायन सिंबलाइजेस द रॉयल ओरिजिन्स ऑफ बुद्ध शाक्यमुनि एज वेल एज हिज करेज इन चैलेंजिंग इनजस्टिस एंड अलिविएटिंग ह्यूमन सफरिंग. ही इज रिफर्ड टू एज लायन ऑफ द शाक्यस, एन एक्नॉलेजमेंट ऑफ द पावर ऑफ हिज टीचिंग. द बुद्धस वॉइस इज ऑफन कॉल्ड द लायन्स रोर, रोरिंग आउट द धर्म फॉर ऑल टू हियर. The symbolic meaning of the lion's roar reminds us to strive with the courageous of the lion king and overcome obstacles in our path. Isse happiness create hoti hai aur harmony aati hai hamari lives aur society mein. Due to these characteristics, the lion has been considered through all ages and centuries as a symbol of royalty and protection, as well as of wisdom. They get their food from hunting, and the male's job is to protect the clan from enemies. The iconographic representation of the lion originated in Persia. In Buddhism, lions are symbolic of bodhisattvas, the sons of the Buddha, or Buddha's lion. Buddhist iconography mein inko dharma protectors mante hain, supporting the throne of the Buddhas and bodhisattvas, serving as the mounts. They are found at the entrance of the monasteries and shrines. Manjushri, the Bodhisattva of great wisdom, mounts a lion symbolized in the Flower Adornment Sutra, also called the Avatamsak Sutra. They roam freely. Ye characteristics hai lion ki, isliye inka ye symbolism bahut popular hai Buddhism mein. They are kings of the doctrine and they are guardians of the temple. Then we have elephants, jinki main characteristic hai strength or steadfastness. It has become a symbol of physical and mental strength as well as responsibility and earthiness. In Indian society, elephants were considered to bring good luck and prosperity. They were owned by kings and used in wars. In Buddhism, the elephant is a symbol of a mental strength. At the beginning of one's practice, the uncontrolled mind is symbolized by a gray elephant who can run wild any moment and destroy everything on his way. After practicing dharma and taming one's mind, the mind which is now brought under control is symbolized by a white elephant, strong and powerful, who can be directed wherever one wishes and destroy all the obstacles on the way. Previous births mein Buddha Shakyamuni was born as an elephant also. For last incarnation as Siddhartha Gautama, he descended from the Tushita Pure Land and entered his mother's womb in the form of a white elephant. मंडल ऑफरिंग का जो रिचुअल है इसमें वी मेक ऑफर्स टू द बुद्ध द प्रेशियस एलिफेंट विद द स्ट्रेंथ ऑफ 1000 एलिफेंट्स. जो एलिफेंट टस्क्स हैं, दीज आर वन ऑफ द 7 रॉयल एम्ब्लेम्स. द एलिफेंट इज द व्हीकल ऑफ द तथागत अक्षोभ्य एंड द डेटी बालभद्र. द एलिफेंट इज अ गार्डियन ऑफ द टेम्पल्स ऑफ द एंड द बुद्ध हिमसेल्फ. नेक्स्ट सिंबल है हॉर्स का. These are means of transport. They run very fast. In previous times, they had wings and could fly. Inki main characteristic hai their loyalty, industriousness, and swiftness. An example of these qualities is Kantak, the horse of Siddhartha Gautama. When the future Buddha left his palace in order to become an ascetic, his horse realized that he will never see his master again, and he died of a broken heart. He was reborn in one of the heavens. Buddhism mein horse is a symbol of energy and effort in the practice of dharma. In that sense, we can quote a passage from one of Milarepa's Song of the Galloping Horse of a Yogi. In the mountain hermitage, which is my body, in temple of my breast, at the summit of the triangle of my heart, the horse, which is my mind, flies like the wind. He gallops on the plains of great bliss. If he persists, he will attain the rank of a victorious Buddha. Going backward, he cuts the root of samsara. Going forward, he reaches the high land of Buddhahood. Astride such a horse, one attains the highest illumination. This has been translated by Losang D. Lalungpa. The so-called wind horse is symbolic of the mind, its vehicle the wind, and it can be ridden upon. That means that we have the possibility of controlling the mind and wind and guide it towards any direction and at any speed that we wish. There are some stories of the Bodhisattva Lokeshwar also taking the shape of a horse in order to help sentient beings. Buddhist iconography mein horse ko dikhaya gaya hai supporting the throne of the Tathagat Ratnasambha and carries the chariot of Surya, the sun god. Next, we have the peacock, which represents wisdom and is associated with the bodhisattvas. The tail of a peacock spreads out around him with his Asia eyes, symbolizing the rise of the thousand arms of bodhisattva Avalokiteshvara and his thousand eyes. Peacocks or snakes ki dushmani hoti hai. It is said that the peacock eats snakes aur unke poison ka koi asar nahi hota hai. And the peacock transforms the poison into amrit or nectar. Similarly, a bodhisattva is able to transform ignorance into enlightenment, desire into generosity, and hatred into compassion. When a person has positive thoughts, his mind becomes open like a peacock, opening his tail and exhibiting its beautiful colors. The peacock is one of the most important birds created by transformation in the Amitabha Sutra, as it supports the throne of Buddha Amitabha of the Western Pure Land. So peacocks are a symbol of openness and acceptance also. Hinduism may be peacock feathers use hote hain. In Buddhism, they symbolize wisdom. They are synonymous with the great bodhisattvas. A bodhisattva is able to take delusions as the path toward liberation and transform the poisonous mind of ignorance, desire, and hatred, that is moha, raga, dvesha, into the thought of enlightenment or bodhicitta, which opens colorfully like the peacock's tail. Here we will quote from a teaching called The Wheel of Sharp Weapons, written by Dharma Rakshit, who passed it to his main disciple Deepankar Shri Gyan, quoted from Atisa. In jungles, a poisonous plant struts the peacocks, though medicine gardens of beauty lie near. The masses of peacocks do not find gardens pleasant, but thrive on the essence of poisonous plants. In similar fashion, the brave bodhisattvas remain in the jungle of world's concern. No matter how joyful this world's pleasure garden, these brave ones are never attracted to pleasures, but thrive in the jungle of suffering and pain. The mind of the sentient beings in this world is like a thick forest of desire and hatred. The pleasures and material possessions are like a beautiful medicinal garden. The brave-minded bodhisattvas, because of having realized the shortcomings of samsara, are not attracted to sansaric pleasures, just as the peacocks are not attracted to medicinal plants. So bodhisattvas or peacocks similar hote hain. By eating poison, the peacock's body becomes healthy and beautiful. He is adorned with five feathers on the head, which symbolize the five paths of the bodhisattva and the attainment of the five Buddha families. They have beautiful colors. So anybody who sees a bodhisattva receives great happiness in his mind. They can develop their mind quickly, attaining higher and higher realization. So peacocks symbolize the transmuting of desire into the path of liberation. Therefore, they are the vehicle of Buddha Amitabha, who represents desire and attachment transmuted into the wisdom of discriminating awareness. Next symbol is Garuda, the king of birds. It is a very big bird. It symbolizes the space element and the power of the sun, which can dry up the waters. He represents the spiritual energy of which he devours the delusion of jealousy. Garuda is also the openness. He can stretch out his wings. He represents the great freedom of the mind, which can open and is not uptight by conflicting emotions. It's the wise mind which reaches everywhere. Specifically in Buddhism, Garuda is related of the perfection of giving, Dan Paramita, just as the rays of the sun give life to the earth. Snake or Garuda ki story hai, aap PDF mein padh lijiyega. In Buddhism, Garuda is the vehicle of Amogha Siddhi, the Buddha who embodies the all-accomplishing wisdom. He is also the vehicle of a form of Lokeshwar Hari Harihar Vahan. Garuda is also a deity of his own. Then we have the phoenix, which is deeply rooted in Chinese and Japanese culture. It is used as emblems of the emperor and empress, shown with the dragon to symbolize a perfect marriage. The phoenix is a benevolent bird, as it does not harm insects and represents the Confucian values of loyalty, honesty, decorum, and justice. Buddhism is ko sacred mante hain. It appears only in times of peace and prosperity. Like the deer, it symbolizes peace and tranquility. It is a mythical creature jo represent karta hai an enlightened one, rising from the ashes of the death of ego. The phoenix is also one of the four spiritual creatures in Chinese mythology. Sadhu, sadhu, sadhu. Now we have our last topic, Buddha's funeral prayers. Just a moment. For funerals and ceremonies, what are the Buddha's prayers? Anicca Vatsankhara. This is the most popular. Please keep your hands in Anjali, folded in front of you. Anicca Vatsankhara. Upadvaya dhammino upajitva nirujhanti tesam bhupa samosukho. This is taken from the Mahaparinibbana Sutta. All things are impermanent. They arise and pass away. Having arisen, they come to an end. Their coming to peace is bliss. Another translation is, impermanent truly are compounded things or conditionings. By nature arising and passing away, having arisen when they are extinguished with insight, their eradication brings happiness. Ye bahut common verse hai, Sri Lanka aur dusri Buddhist countries mein bhi. Funerals mein isko emphasize karte hain kyunki ye fleeting nature of life dikhata hai. It has a deep meaning and explains why we face sorrow inevitably, because death is inevitable. This verse was uttered by Sakka, the king of the Devas, just after the Parinibbana of the Buddha. It is in the Mahaparinibbana Sutta, Digh Nikaya 16, aur isko three times repeat kiya jata hai. We generate our future rebirths via our own Abhisankhara. We need to stop creating Abhisankara with Lobha, Dosa, Moha to attain the Nibbanic bliss. Funeral chanting jo Theravad Buddhism mein hai, uska order ye hai. We will provide you with the link to a YouTube video. Usme text bhi diya hua hai. Agar aap description mein jayenge, to you will get the link to the text which you can download from Google Drive. Ye order hai, sabse pehle number one, namo tas bhagavato arahato three times bolte hain. Number two, dham sangani matika ya matika. Three, pathan matika patho. Four, vipassana bhumi patho. Five, Karaniya Metta Sutta, and number six, Anicca Vatsankhara. May all beings be released from suffering. Funerals or ceremonies mein aur kya kya hum pad sakte? Maranusati, meditation on death, jiske keval first verse maine yaha pe di hai. Pavat deep tulyaya, sayu santati yakhayam, parupa maya sampasam, Bhavaye maranasatim. Like a flame blown out by the wind, this life continuum goes to destruction. Recognizing one's similarities to others, one should develop mindfulness of death. Maranusati ka paath kiya ja sakta hai, meditation on death. Patanumodana, sharing merits. Hum jo bhi chanting karte hain regularly, daily basis pe, uske baad hum sharing of merits kar sakte hain, dedicate them to those who are diseased. Buddha puja, offering to the Buddha, hum kar sakte hain. Any other suttas like the Mangal Sutta, Ratana Sutta, Paritta for the welfare of those family members who are left behind. And let me remind you, ye sab sentient beings ke liye hota hai. Isliye hum animals or humans, dono ke liye same karte hain. Buddhist funeral rituals kya hain? Sabse pehle bahut bhikshuon ko amantrit karna chahiye. That goes without saying. Without the guidance of venerable bhikshus and bhikshunis, it is not possible. Uske atirik jo bhi rites and rituals hai, wo hum discuss karenge isme. Buddhist funeral rites kai tarike ki hoti hain. Generally, ek funeral service hoti hai with an altar to the deceased being. Prayers and meditation hoti hai and the body is cremated after the service. Buddhist funeral customs mein hota hai, offering cloth to the monk on the deceased behalf, decorating the altar with an image of the deceased person and the Buddha, pouring water from a vessel into an overflowing cup. Walking with sticks to symbolize ki hame support chahiye apne grief mein, chanting or singing appropriate sutras or prayers, bringing offerings such as flowers, candles, and fruits, burning incense, ringing gong or bell. Buddhist funerals mein kya hota hai? Around the world, there are many denominations of Buddhism, each of which adheres to a different set of rites and customs. However, at the core of the faith is the belief in the cycle of life, sansara, reincarnation, good deeds, and enlightenment. The rituals that take place around death and funerals are to help the deceased in the future life. Buddhist tradition suggests that death should occur in a calm and peaceful environment with close friends and family in attendance. We should reflect on the good deeds jo dying person ne kiye hain aur ye hope karna chahiye ki next reincarnation mein ye help karenge. Family or friends ko good deeds karne chahiye on behalf of them aur merit dedicate karna chahiye. Nibbanas pachayo hotu. Let me return to the main screen. That is the end of today's topic. Sadhu, sadhu, sadhu. May I now request Venerable Bhante Sumita to close today's lecture by transferring merit and giving his blessings.
Okay, by the power of the merit that we all accrued today, may all devas and all other sentient beings be able to share this merit, receive this merit. May they be well, happy, healthy, safe, wherever they are. Please think in thus, transfer merits to the devas. Akasattha cha bhummattha devanaga mahiddhika. Punyantang anumoditva chirang rakkhantu loka sasanam. Akasaddha cha bhummaddha devanaga mahiddhika. Punyantang anumoditva chirang rakkhantu dhamma desanam. Akasaddha cha bhummaddha devanaga mahiddhika. Punyantang anumoditva chirang rakkantu tvam sada. And then transferring merits to devas and departed ones, please think of your all the departed ones and transfer merits to all of them. Idang me nyatinang hotu sukhita huntu nyatayo. Idang me nyatinang hotu sukhita huntu nyatayo. Idang me nyatinang hotu sukhita huntu nyatayo. Suhamitta Patana, aspiration for wonderful spiritual friends in our life throughout our samsara. Please recite this stanza. For spiritual friends. Imina punya kammena mame bala samagamo satang samagamo hotu yava nibbana pattiya. Nibbana pattana as the final goal of all of us. We think of all the merits that we have done today and before. We will also pray and wish that we be able to attain the supreme bliss of Nibbana as soon as possible. Thinking thus, let us recite this gatha. Idang me punyam asavakhaya vaham hotu. Idang me punyam asavakhaya vaham hotu. Idang me punyam asavakkhaya vaham hotu. पमुंचतु सब भया पमुंचतु सब रोगा पमुंचतु। साधु साधु
साधु
साधु। थैंक यू
साधु
एवरीवन, एंड जस्ट वांट टू आल्सो लेट यू नो दैट वी हैव जस्ट अ फ्यू डेज लेफ्ट नाउ, एंड सो वी विल हैव अ फाइनल प्रेजेंटेशन ऑफ ऑल ऑफ यू ऑन अक्टूबर 18। ओके, सो प्लीज बी रेडी फॉर दैट, and that will be very important, and let's see how much how many people are ready, and if you are if you have any question you can also ask, and in the group or in the live chat you can ask, and yeah, we'll work on that. Thank you so much, and see you again next on Monday. Thank you, bye bye.